English actor Olivia Colman has a new movie out this week. It's called Wicked Little Letters, and it's a period piece that's been described as scandalously sweary.
I was lucky enough to talk dirty with her, as she told me all about it.
Your Majesty.
Olivia Colman really is a queen, whether it's drama or comedy.
Did you just look at me? Did you? Look at me! Look at me! How dare you! Close your eyes!
Her sensitivity in every role is unmistakable.
I like you, Rose.
I hate her!
You don't like the idea of me leaving this house, do you?
She's now starring alongside one of her best mates, Jessie Buckley, in a true crime black comedy about an English town in the 20s that becomes the scene of a scandalous poison pen letter case.
Edith Swan takes it up the and she loves it more than Christmas Day.
Only words matter.
She sucks 10 a week, minimum.
Holy heavens.
In the end, I think it's just jealousy.
You're the star and a producer of this film. What drew you to the project?
I thought it was funny, and I thought it would be really fun to do. And when you very sweetly say producer, I didn't really do much on that side of it.
I bet you do.
I didn't. Thanks.
And then because you were involved in the casting as well, you got to involve your good friend, Jessie.
Yeah.
Okay, I did do that. How awesome was that? Yeah,
so, yes, I did say I want Jessie to do it, because I thought, I mean, going to work with one of your best friends is, you know, why wouldn't you? And we swear at each other for free. Anyway, we might as well do it, you know, get paid.
It seems astounding that it's a true story. Because, I mean, obviously, being in the side of the world, I'd never heard of the story before.
No, well,
but
I
it seems astounding.
On that side of the world, I know. And I love the fact that we just assume in the 20s nobody swore, everyone was very well behaved. And they weren't. Because 85% of the letters are from the real letters. They were, yeah, foul-mouthed.
I'd probably say that you look like f***ing Queen Victoria shoved a f***ing nettle up her f***ing I don't know.
You stick f***ing cakes you make look like this some f***ing arsehole.
Better.
It does highlight an incredible double standard between men and women, particularly with foul language.
I mean, there's still double standards with swearing. You know, still, you still meet women who think it's unladylike, which is a phrase which needs to be buried.
It struck me that I was watching it thinking, is this the sweariest movie of all time? Because
I don't think it's the sweariest.
Well,
is
it's
it?
Not. I've done the research.
Oh, have you? Brilliant. Oh, goody. Tell
so
me.
So here we go. I just looked at the top three.
Yeah.
And I don't think the top two count because the top one is Swearnet the movie, which is about swearing.
Okay.
So, of course, it's going to be swearing.
Yeah.
Then there is the documentary, which is obviously about. So
brilliant.
That doesn't count. So the next blockbuster that has the most swear words is Wolf of Wall Street.
And it has that would have a lot.
680 expletives and 506
Wow.
So I don't think you've got
any
that. I don't know how many I can't believe I'm saying these
I'm
words
enjoying
with
this
Olivia
so much.
Colman.
It's so much fun, isn't it?
But it is
a lovely release, isn't it? We're instantly giggling.
Did you just lose it from time to time?
Oh, God, we got the giggles, so badly. And particularly, there was one in the market square where Jessie runs at me. We took ages to do that. We just kept giggling. Also, you know when she flashes her bum? She wasn't meant to do that.
She just decided to go
She'd entertain everybody, but they liked it so much. And she went, I'm going to have to do it 10 times now. Because they said, yes, keep that, that's hilarious. We did have too much fun making it, and I do love, there is a serious side to it. It's the swearing is real, it really happened. The women that are doing it, I love Edith, that she has no agency, she has no power, and she has to have a release of some kind. Repress a woman, it's going to backfire. And I love that looking at Rose now, she's the woman we all want to be, we aspire to be her, but back then everyone was going, oh, it's shocking example of womanhood. And, an unmarried mother.
New Zealand audiences got to know Olivia Colman best as Detective Sergeant Ellie Miller in the crime drama Broadchurch. It was a gripping whodunit, with only one member of the cast accidentally finding out who done it.
We made a list of people who might have done it.
These are all your friends.
We know.
When I first went to meet the producers, to talk, no, to sort of, will you do the part?
Yes.
And I said, but who did it? And then they told me. And I went, no! And they went, that's what we want. Good, OK, that's a good reaction, great. And then I hadn't even got home, like a 20-minute train journey back, and they phoned and went, we really that up. We've decided we don't want anyone to know. We'd love everyone to just experience it. I went, OK. So can you pretend you don't know? OK. So I had to not tell all of my mates, you know, who became really good friends. I'm just lying all the way through it.
So they didn't think you knew?
No. When David Tennant found out that I knew...
Trouble.
He went, you f***ing kidding! You knew! I'm so sorry!
Her resume of roles is impressive, and so are the accolades. BAFTAs, Golden Globes, and an Academy Award for Best Actress in 2019.
This is the first Oscar and nomination for Olivia Colman.
For her glorious portrayal of Queen Anne in The Favourite.
Everyone leaves me. Dies.
Obviously, such an amazing win. We were on the red carpet when you came out. Oh, we were so excited to see you. Thanks. Anyway, but I'm wondering, with Emma winning this year, and she was in The Favourite as well.
I know.
How excited were you for her?
So excited. We had a little exchange of voice messages just to each other. Oh, and her speech. Oh, so beautiful. I had a little cry. Oh. Just... Oh, couldn't happen to a lovelier person. Twice.
And you know what it means to win an Academy Award.
Yeah.
What has it meant for your career? I mean, do you just have to turn down so many offers of doing movies?
I don't know. It's impossible to know, you know, what would have happened if I hadn't won it. I don't know. I think it hasn't been a bad thing. it was an incredible thing to have happened. I'll cherish that. And I just hope I keep working. And, you know, I do things I want to do, which is, I'm really blessed. And this was, you know, this turned up, I thought this would be fun. And maybe next year I'll do something a bit more, I don't know, sad. I don't know, there's no game plan. And I've no idea how it might have affected things. But I'm lucky, I feel very lucky that I'm working.
Well, this is a wonderful project, and I love the movie. So thank you so much for sparing a bit of time for us down in New Zealand. It's lovely
thank
to meet you and to talk to you.
And I'm sure my husband would say, please say hello to New Zealand.
OK. Thank you very much.
And if you're wondering why Olivia's husband would want to say hello to New Zealand, he was brought up here as a child. He spent the first 11 years of his life growing up in Kohimarama in Auckland.
In Kohimarama.
Yeah, so you might have gone to primary school with him. His name was Ed Sinclair.